What's good with y'all, man? In this video, I want to touch on why I do psychedelics. The reason that I do psychedelics, I think the reason why a lot of people do psychedelics on an unconscious level is because once you tap into this energy, you realize how powerful the mind really is. And how there really are no excuses in this life of what you can and cannot do. And essentially the only limitations that we have are those in which we place upon ourselves. So when you tap into psychedelics, whether that be acid, shrooms, DMT, ayahuasca, salvia, all of the different mind-altering drugs and spirit molecules, excuse me, personally, for me, what I've realized in my experience with psychedelics is that you just tap into a different form of thought, a different frequency, and it's something that can only be achieved on psychedelics. And the high isn't sustainable always, so it's something that's very coveted, and it's something that you don't want to always be going for. You don't always want to be reaching out for it, because then you'll develop a dependency. But I think the key is to always be in control and have a certain awareness when you're under the influence of these substances, and allow it to take over and allow it to do its job, right? Allow this medicine to essentially really take place and really take hold inside of you. I do psychedelics because it really puts me back in tune with who I am, and more specifically where I am, right? Not necessarily geologically where I am, but just in this point in my life, right? At this exact moment in my life, what I'm doing, who I am, why I'm doing it. And again, breaks down the ego wall, just breaks down that character armor that we build up for ourselves, because we have to have a certain edge toward the world, toward our family, toward our friends, people that we're in relationships with. We have to build up this certain image to protect what we have inside, to protect all of the vulnerability that's inside of us, right? And when I make these type of videos, it's not so much about me being vulnerable. It's more so about me being transparent, right? Because I think these are thoughts and a certain energy that is inside all of us, right? It's something that we can all kind of tap into, but not many people want to express it. Not many people have the words to articulate it or get it out. And again, psychedelics does a really good job, acid in particular, of breaking down the ego, just diminishing it just a little bit, so you can really look at yourself in the mirror and apologize to yourself, man, for selling yourself short. Because like I said, you will begin to realize that there are no limitations. The mind is very, very powerful. The mind is extremely powerful. And possibilities are endless. What you can create, what you can conceive, how you can relay different messages, how you can see things from different perspectives. The possibilities are endless, man. So we only limit ourselves when we are fearful to dive into these substances. We're fearful to give it a shot. And do I recommend everybody try acid? I don't. It's not for everybody. If you don't have the mental strength, the spiritual strength, the emotional capacity to handle this this substance, it might not be for you. Because what it'll do, it'll regurgitate everything that's within, right? Now, if you have a lot of pent up energy and a lot of things that are deeply rooted in a state of denial, right? Denial of who you are, your true nature, if you're constantly putting on a facade or a mask or this image to the world. When you do psychedelics, all of that is going to be regurgitated. Then you can look at yourself in the mirror like, fuck, I've been lying to myself this whole time. And no, I'm not confessing anything right now because I live my truth and I'm a very genuine and authentic human being. But again, once I tap into this state of mind, this frequency is so coveted because everything becomes clear. Everything becomes clear and it's beautiful. It's beautiful, man. Do I recommend that you try psychedelics or acid in particular? Depend on where you are, depend on your frame of mind, depending on your mental development, you know, what you can handle. And as far as age, the brain is measured by maturity, not by age. So if you're a younger person and you're thinking about tapping into these substances or you're ready to try something new or experience this profound and imminent episode of life, man. It's, I don't know. I honestly don't know how people can go their full human existence without trying it. So if you are a younger individual, no, I'm not encouraging you to try it, but at your own risk. Because it's beautiful once you can really tap in and uncover all of the built up nasty, evil shit that you got inside of you. From harboring onto these negative emotions and thought and fear-based emotions. Once you can get all of that out, once you can get all of that to come out, then I think that's where the beauty of psychedelics really lies, and you can begin to appreciate yourself and really, really vibrate in an energy of love with yourself. No one else, man. I'm not with anybody right now, but I feel better than I felt in a while. Just even speaking to myself on camera, I don't even know if I'll upload this video, right? But it's just a beautiful feeling, a beautiful feeling being able to express these things and in complete and honest transparency, right? So a big reason I do psychedelics is because at the end of the day, man, that casket ain't got no bunk bed. That casket is for one. That grave is for one. So when you return back to the earth, when it's just you and nobody else, that's why I do psychedelics, because it brings me back into who I am and my true nature. And it reminds me I don't need anyone else. And I came into this world by myself and I'm gonna leave by myself. And that's not to sound selfish or to act as if I don't need people in this physical reality. It's more so when it comes down to it, I put all faith into myself and my ability, what I can accomplish and what I can conquer. And again, all psychedelics is going to do is get you to this primal state, this primal foundation of life and self-acceptance, right? The self-acceptance and not appeasing to the expectations of anyone else. Because when you know what you have built up, you know the battles that you fought, you know the dark places that you've been mentally, right? Your dark place may not be measurable to another person's dark place, but it's unique to you. So you face those demons alone and you go through what you got to go through. And once you tap into the substance, once you can really tap in, right? Because not all acid is gonna get you to this place. Not all shrooms is gonna get you to this place. But the right amount, mixed with the silence. The silence. The silence is profound. It helps a lot. It's like therapy. It's a solo therapy session, man. That's the biggest way I can describe my love for this drug, for this medicine. A solo therapy session, man. You versus you. Everything that you have built in, everything that you have like repressed, all of that energy, bring it up to the surface and deal with it and battle it and conquer it, right? Because again, when I say once you can control everything that's up here and in here and what's coming out of here, nobody can stop you. Nobody can. I guarantee you the outside world will not faze you. I guarantee Trump, Biden, Kamala Harris, Mike Pence, Republican, Democrat, Christianity, Muslim, it won't faze you. It won't faze you. Because you won't fear death. You will not fear death. I have no fear of death, and I know I'm not immortal. And I know one day that day will come, but it is what it is, man. I'm gonna live this life to its fullest capacity and experience everything that I can experience in this on this physical realm. And boy, this is a beautiful experience. Fuck, this is potent right now. This is extremely potent. Am I endorsing psychedelics? Yes, I am. But again, it's not for everybody. It's not for everybody. So I'm not saying just go out and do it willy-nilly, but go out and do it under in a controlled environment. If you know what you can handle, if mentally you know what you can handle, that's what it comes down to, right? If you're a person that has a lot of shit built up in you, and you're a person that doesn't express or you don't live authentically in your truth, it might not be for you. It might not be for you. I love y'all, man.